Hello guys and welcome to Python Programming Tutorials by Amul's Academy. In the previous tutorial, we discussed about the namespace and variable scope. Part of the program where variable or names are accessible is called as variable scope, right? And in that there will be four types. One is local, global, built-ins and enclosed scope. So today we'll discuss about that. And also we'll see what is this LEGB rule. Okay, so first of all, the four types are: first one is local, second one is global, and third one is enclosed, and fourth one is built-in. Okay, so first, local scope. It contains names defined inside the current function. Okay, if we define any variable inside a function, then the scope of that variable is inside that function. When the function ends, the availability of the variable also ends. Okay, so next is global. It contains names defined at the top level of the module, or we can say beginning of the script, and these names are available for the whole script. The lifetime of the names ends when the program ends. Okay. Whatever the variable we use in the local scope are called as local variables. If we use functions, then they are called as local functions. Whatever the variable we use in the global scope is called as global variables, and the functions are called as global functions. And third one is enclosed scope. So it contains names defined inside any and all enclosing function. So if we take the nested function, if we define a function inside another function, then that is called as nested function. In that case, we can see the enclosed scope. We'll take the example, okay? Variable declared here is called as enclosed variable. The last one is built-in scope. It contains names built into the Python language through the special built-in modules. Okay, so it contains built-in names. So local scope contains local names. It contains names inside the current functions. Global scope contains names which are defined at the beginning of the script or module. Enclosed is the names within the enclosed functions, and built-in are the built-in names. Okay, so we'll take example now. Okay, so in the Python file, first I'll define a function, okay? I'll give name as inner. You can give any name to this function. I'll take a variable called x equal to 4 and I'll print that. Okay, so outside this, I'll call that function. If I don't call that function, it won't execute, right? So here, we can see the names as inner x. Okay, we can see two names. So here, inner is the function name and x is the variable name. So we'll talk about the variable now, okay? So here we can see inner is defined beginning of the script. So it is, this function is available for whole script, okay? We can call wherever I want here in the script. But here we can see this variable. It is defined inside this function, right? So the lifetime of this function is inside this function. Scope of this is inside this function. So this is the local variable. Okay, this is the local scope of this variable. Okay, so here x is the local variable. The availability of the x ends when this function ends. Okay, so that's nothing but if I save this and run this now, it will print 4. Okay, the value of x, here we can see the print. But if I try to access this variable outside this function, okay, here I'll take, after this inner function, I'll just try to print x again. Okay, so now if I save this and run this, here we can see the name error. First it will print x is equal to 4. That is the output for this. When we call the function, it will print x. Next, here we can see the print x again. So it will give name error because x is not defined. Because this x is only available inside this function, we can't access it outside the function. Because x is the local variable, okay? So next what I'll do is, I'll take another variable and I'll define here y is equal to 10, Okay, so next I'll print y here. Print so y. I'm printing outside the function. Okay, and here inside also I'll print that. Inside the function y. Okay, so now if I save this and run this, here we can see it will print the result. y equal to 10, x is equal to 4, inside the function also y equal to 10. Because y defined at the beginning of the script, it is the global variable. It can be accessed in any part of this program. We can access this variable wherever we want. Okay, that's why it's called as global variable. So here x is the local variable, y is the global variable, and I can print the y value inside the function also, outside the function also, but x can be accessed only in the function body. So next what I'll do is, here I'll define y as 5 inside this function. Here we can see there is a variable called y. Okay, this is the global variable. Here again I'll assign a new value to this y inside this function. Now if I save this and run this, here we can see y is equal to 10, x is equal to 4, inside the function y is equal to 5. Okay, so here inside this function y value is 5. So now if I try to modify the global variable, that is y, inside the local scope or inside this function, then what will happen? So here I'll take y is equal to y plus 1. Okay, so first I took y is equal to 5, I assigned a new value to this variable y. Now what I'm doing is I'm changing the global value in the local scope. If I do that, here we can see the unbound local error. So we are getting the error because we can't modify the global variable inside the local scope. If you want to do that, then you should use a keyword that is called as global. So if you write global y, okay, then if you want, you can modify the global variable here inside the local scope. Now if I save this and run this, now here we can see y is equal to 10, x is equal to 4, inside the function y is 11. Okay, so after this, if I print this here, okay, after calling this function, I'll print y value. Okay, so now if I see this, here we can see x 4, inside the function y 11, y 11, because it will modify the global variable. Okay, so it will modify the original value. Okay, so to modify the global variable inside the local scope, you need to use global keyword. Next, I'll take nested function now. Okay, so here I'll define a function called def outer. I'll take a variable called z4, and I don't want this. And here I'll call the inner function. Outside here I'll call the outer function. And here I'll print z value. Here we can see x4, inside the function y10. Z is equal to 4. Here the variable z, okay, it is local to the outer function, but it is non-local to inner function. For the inner function, z is not the local variable as well as it is not the global variable. So that's why it is called as non-local variable, and this is also called as enclosing variable. Okay, so this is the enclosing scope. Here z is the enclosed variable. So we can access this z inside the outer function as well as inner function. Okay, here we can say I accessed inside the outer function. We can do that inside this function also. So if I write instead of y, I'll take z. Here we can see x4 inside the function z is 4, here also 4. Okay, so if I take z value as 15, x4 inside the function z is 15, outside the function also z 15. Okay, so next, similar to the global keyword, we can use non-local keyword to modify the enclosed variable in the local scope. Okay, so here we can see z is equal to 15. If I write here, z is equal to z plus 1. Okay, I'm trying to modify the enclosed variable inside the local scope. So here we can see the error, unbound local error. Okay, so we can't do that. To do this, I just use non-local. We can see this is the keyword. And if I mention z, now if I execute this, it will do the changes. Okay, to modify the enclosed variable in the local scope, we need to use non-local. To modify the global variable inside the local scope, we need to use global keyword. Okay, so this is about the global variable, local variable, as well as enclosed variable. Next, last is built-in scope. Okay, so in the built-in scope, it contains built-in names, so we can access wherever we want. Okay, so no need to define anything, we can directly use that names. For example, here I'll use print. Okay, so we didn't define a function called print, right? Then how I am accessing it? Because this is the built-in function, that's why we are accessing it, right? If I go for range function, for keywords, these are all already defined. Okay, so these are all the built-in names. Okay, so now we discussed about the local, global, enclosed and built-in scope. But if every scope contains the same variable name, and if we are using this, here we can see x is defined in the global scope, x is in enclosed scope and also local scope. Okay, we can see the local variable, global variable and enclosed variable. And here we are printing the x value. So how Python will search for this value? How Python will get to know which x value it should print? Whether it should print 15 now, 10 or 5. Okay, so if I save this and run this, we can see the output, that is 15. This is printing the local value. Okay, local variable value. But how Python will do this? That is done by using LEGB rule. That's nothing but L stands for local. Okay, so LEGB rule. So here L stands for local. Okay, next E stands for enclosed. Next it is global. Next, lastly, it is built-in. So that is nothing but Python will first search in the local scope. It will search for the name in the local scope. If it is not found, then it will search in the enclosed scope. If it is not found, it will search in the global scope. If it is not found, it will search in the built-in scope. Then also it is not found, it will give name error. Okay, here when we are printing the x value, it will search in the local scope. X is equal to 15, we can see the value, so it will print 15. If I comment this now, okay, so it will search here in the local scope, it won't find the name x, so it will go to the next higher scope, that is enclosed scope, and it will print 10. So now here we can see it will print 10. Okay, so if I comment this also, it will print 5 because it will search in the local scope. If it is not found, it will go to the enclosed scope. If it is also not found, then it will go to the global scope. And here it is defined, so it will print 5. Here we can see. Okay, so here also if I comment this and if I run this, it will give name error because first it will search in the local scope, it is not found. It will go to the enclosed scope, it is not found. It will go to the global scope, it is not found. It will search in the built-in scope. Built-in scope also it is not found. That's why it will print the name error. Okay. So this is about the LEGB rule. Okay. Local, enclosed, global, built-in. That's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.